And I see lots of my clients, peer, friends, everybody is going through the same mistakes, and that is the reason digital is not working for them. Digital cannot be learned, by the way. Digital is absolutely a mindset. It has nothing to do with technology. I don't want to talk long on my bio. I run a digital consulting firm which is called Digital Fellow. You can Google me. And I see lots of my clients, peer, friends, everybody is going through the same mistakes, and that is the reason digital is not working for them. So I'm going to talk on this topic, primarily why most of the digital marketing is failing on mobile. I'm going to have some myth, I'm going to bust those myths. So all of you who come from marketing background, who come from traditional marketing or just finishing few MBA or your end of last year of your MBA, you'll figure out how marketing helps digital also. You will not be able to manage digital primarily from a very in isolation format. Understanding of branding, advertising, marketing is very, very important for understanding digital. So let us first understand what is digital marketing and why it fails will come later part. Most important, I see everybody who get into the digital marketing, they want to do lead generation. Being a client, being an agency, or being a brand endorser, they just jump into lead generation. I know I just finished, built my company, a store or a shop or a product. Let's do lead generation. It doesn't work like that. Lead generation is nothing to do with digital marketing. Lead generation is a very minute part of digital marketing. It's one of the clusters, it's not whole. So if you are jumping into straight lead generation, it will not work for you. Most of the people think AdWords is only digital marketing. You know, I see a lot of people who are clients also, they do AdWords. They look out for, you have a website, you have a Facebook, and you are doing some AdWords and you think you're digital. Absolutely no, there's nothing to do with digital. Digital doesn't work like that. This is another biggest thing I see. Most of the clients, agency, everybody who I come across is that they post on social media. And they think and they feel I'm doing digital. That's not digital. Posting means nothing. Posting means nothing if you are doing digital marketing in a very aggressive manner, in a very perfect manner. Posting is for you and I, if you want to share some photographs or images or video, that's fine. If you want to do business out of it, posting doesn't help you. There are methods and techniques of even posting. Product selling, everybody I see, most of them, the moment they give you, you know, a traditional guy, generally a brand and custodian or a marketing head is 30 plus or 27 plus. This is the age group, they become a marketing head or a brand head. And since we didn't, digital was not so long, everybody start using digital from a traditional lens. You know what they do? They start selling. I see number of website. If you go through any website, you will figure out most of the website, content, blog, everybody is trying to sell. Digital doesn't work like that. You're supposed to sell stuff at the lower bottom. There's a process called tofu, mofu, and bofu. Top of the funnel, you are not supposed to sell, you're supposed to educate. Middle of the funnel, you're supposed to compare and say what is good and what how it is working. The last part is bofu, where you make that user believe that why they will decide to, you know, decision-making stage happen on the level. That is where you should sell. Most of the content, videos, POP, broadcast, podcast, social media, everybody's selling. So none of the digital marketing will work. You're not supposed to sell from top to bottom. You're supposed to sell in the time when he has in the consideration stage. So why I'm saying all this thing, you know, this is the biggest problem. This one problem kills everybody. A top CEO, 55 years old, 60 year old, his mom, his dad, son who got into the business. In fact, I also speak, I think, 50 business school I've covered so far. I am a faculty for the last 4 years from IIM Indore. I am in fact going IIM Kashipur this weekend. So 50 business schools I've covered, including Nasi Manji, Raheja, you name it, I've gone here, everywhere, across India I'm talking, not just Bombay. I see not of the much business school teaches digital marketing. You know what they do? I have people around me, in fact, he's from Keynote University, I picked him up 3 years back. I have a person who is Kostav, I can't see, he's from IMT Nagpur. Most of the places, these are people who work with me. In fact, I went to the campus and they said, Shubha, I would like to work with you. Most of these courses, even if the courses, people who are sitting here who are from the MBS college, you have digital marketing class one day or two day in a year, and you do little bit of social media, 5 blogs, 4 videos, 3 YouTube, and all of you are self-proclaimed digital marketeer. Life will hit you once you reach a client's, once you start working. Digital is absolutely a mindset. It is nothing to do with technology. Most CEOs, CXOs, marketing heads, pseudo fake digital marketeer falls to this trap. They try to show off. If I ask, if you ask anyone, how many articles you have written or on a LinkedIn, not much will raise hands. If you ask how many, not retweet, how many tweet you have done on a consecutive manner, most people have must have forgotten Twitter handle, password. Facebook, all we all know. Twitter, we don't know. So it's a mindset. If you are having an old mindset, how hard you try, digital will fail. You know what? What you do? You have a, because in the MBA school or the people who are right now in 35, 40 year age, they have come from a traditional school. They do the same mistake. So this is the mistake they do, because they try to see digital in a very different perspective. Digital should be used. Digital cannot be learned, by the way. In fact, I see lots of courses. In fact, I have made a lot of courses on digital marketing on Simply Learn. If you do a course after MBA, you know what you do? Most of the people I see you do, or a professional who is a 4 or 5 years experience, is struggling, and in the LinkedIn you have to write, I'm a digital marketer, otherwise next job you will have a problem. So these are all fake people who comes up, and these are the people who do courses with 50,000, 20,000 and have certifications. Certification doesn't take you anywhere else, because your mindset has to be different. What is a mindset? How much content do you consume? How much tweet you do? How much social media you do? How much blogs you're reading? Who are the followers you're following? That's what makes your digital mindset. Okay? Netflix and binge watching doesn't make you a digital fellow or a digital marketeer. It doesn't, right? So yeah, so most important part, desktop content is not mobile content. I see most of the CEOs, CXOs, and big companies, 5,000 crore turnover companies. You know what they do? They do a desktop design first. Then they try to fit that design into a mobile. That's not digital marketing. So when you do in a digital era, your website should be mobile first. I don't see much people also even investing or even know the function or the importance of user experience, UX. People think they are aliens. No. We don't need that. We are just starting. It doesn't work, because eye, neurological signs, hands, thumb are all movement by which a user experience guy try to control and try to make you read that content. So if you try to copy that and push into a mobile screen, it will never work. If you go through any of your website, I can bet my life, people who are sitting here who are college student, please open your college or any school, 5 business schools website, and try to read their content. Most of the content are desktop heavy. They have pushed into a mobile. If you're not able to read it, you'll get a headache, right? Next. A good user interface is something most people don't understand. People think, what has happened is that I see, because I also come from a traditional school. I'm not born in the millennials time like you guys, right? So I see most of the people who are a DTP operator, 20 years they've worked in an agency or a firm, they have converted themselves as a self-proclaimed graphic designer, and the same graphic designer is looking for a 5th or 7th or 8th job, have to say something so that he gets money or he can control or demand a good job. He said, I am a UX designer. It's a certification course for 3 years to be a UX designer. Not much people know this. So I see a lot of fake people around me. Everybody. Half of the people who are web developer are trying to make them user experience. I will tell you all the tricks how to catch this fake and how you should protect yourself if you want to grow your career into designing or content or anything else. I'll come to that part later on. This is the first mistake most of the people do who are brand owners. They try to make a desktop first and then try to push into mobile. 80% of our traffic comes from mobile, not from desktop. So desktop is a mindset. You should not talk about desktop. You should say everything about them. You know the difficulty? The moment you try to take a desktop content and push it into a 4-inch screen, you will find, oh my God, there are too many lines, I need to cut. That is a problem, we'll figure out. Next, oh, another one of my favorite topic. Traditional content writer is not digital content writer. So I see everybody is a content writer, you know. Everybody I come across, you know, say, I'm a content writer. Okay, wow, wonderful. So I tell them, okay, so what type of content you write? No, I write all type of content, food, blogging, X, Y, Z, whatever. Okay, good. So are you a certified SEO? That's not my job. I'm not an SEO, I only write. As a digital person, without SEO, you will not able to write. You know whom are you writing for? You're not writing for first the human press. You're writing for a spider called Google crawler. If he cannot find your content, human race will never find you. So if you don't know SEO, what are you going to do with your content? Okay, next. This is amazing. Random content, you know. So if you ask everybody is influencer, I see everybody is writing content, blogging, you know, randomly, not knowing whatever they're doing. And they're guessing and they feel very proud. I have 5 videos in YouTube, I have 20 blogs, I'm on everywhere. But what is a context? What type of content you're doing? Whom are you writing? Who is the user? What is his buying cycle? What is his user journey? In that user journey, how you're sprinkling content on the user funnel? That is how you make a contextual content. Do you make biryani or do you eat biryani early morning at 6 o'clock? No. So you're actually surfing content at the wrong time. You don't need it. So it doesn't work. Next. Oh, this I find. English content. Texting, you know, I can't tell you, one of my ex-boss, I said, sir, we need to hire, when I was working a few years back, we need to hire a content writer. He said, why do you need a content writer? Traditional guy? See, there are so many people in the flow writing mails to each other. They all write, so ask them to write content. And I decided to quit that job because I can't work with that boss. So if you write English, it has nothing to do with SEO. SEO is very, very important thing which you should, if you follow Neil Patel, please write down the students if you want to learn. If you should follow Neil Patel, you will understand what is the importance of SEO. If you write anything and it get found, the reason, if I give any of you my visiting card, my card has nothing. When I say nothing, nothing. No email address, no mobile number, no hashtags, no handle, nothing, just the name and the founder. You know, right, the reason? If any of you sitting here try to write Subhobroto Chakraborty is a very long word, you don't want to do that. First of all, type your first name, Anju, Sanjay, whatever, right? Google will not able to find you. Write, not even write my full name, just write S-U-B-H-O. The moment you finish first 4 or 5 characters on your phone search, Google will tell you, are you looking for Subhobroto? So my name will come on the first and second. You know what I did? I've done 0 SEO. I've not paid a paid SEO. I've never paid a single money to Google. I've never do a paid campaign. I'm 3 years old, so how can I do that? All of you can do that. All you do, you write contextual content, and each content image, I use some code called alt text. So Google crawler will find, and they will find this is one Subhobroto who has numerous type of content, all fresh content coming every day. Guess how many content I produce every day as I'm talking right now in front of you? More than 100 content every day. Every single day, 100 content. How to do that? I'll teach you. It's so simple. I'll come to that part. I'll tell you how to do that. All of you can do that. So there's no magic. So content, just writing will not take you far. This is another thing. So everybody likes followers and views. I hope you know that Instagram is taking this, chopping this off. There's no like is going to be there. You know. So what you got? So one of the influencers called me, Shubhu, what do I do then now? They're chopping off the like, you know, how will I survive? How will I get my money from my client? Because I get money if I show them likes. Likes means nothing. Engagement, likes is a part of an engagement. Share is important. If someone share your content, it is 10 times powerful than likes and love or whatever sign. If they start sharing, if they start commenting, the commenting about the content, whatever posting, it has tremendous value. You know, these are important. Likes means nothing. Most people, most of the content that I come across or content people, they don't understand this difference. They can't tell me what is the difference between an article and a blog, checklist and a white paper. They don't know. So if you don't know this math or grammar of writing even content, how long will you fool? Because very soon, younger people who are just coming out of the colleges, they are reading all this content. And people who are around, you know, bloggers, I see around 27 to 35 are the people who don't have much time to read. They're actually trying to get their EMI, the money, family support, because they don't have much time to read. So younger people will come and they will take their jobs. Okay. By the way, one information I must tell you, which I learned, is that Vogue, Cosmopolitan, all of you know? Do you know most of the 40% of the content which we read on Vogue and all is not written by humans? Yeah, robots. And you can also do the same thing. There are certain tools. You pay $1 or $2, give certain content, keywords, and the subject, and artificial intelligence will search, do research, give you original content. $35 to $40 is what they charge every month. So if you don't know this, content marketing or content manager will be a difficult part in after 4 or 5 years time from now. This I see everywhere. Everybody is praying content and they're praying that someone will see their post. It doesn't work like that in digital. In hoarding it does, not in digital marketing. They just post, spray content, and they assume, oh, one day someone will see, wow, I've done so many. One to someone will see at least. I'm going 100. Digital marketing doesn't work like that, okay? Paid PR is not as equal to organic PR. Organic PR is what I get is that this guy called me. They have been, I think, calling for the last 2 years, if I'm not wrong. I think 2 years, I think they're calling me. So imagine what is a paid organic peer. So they, in their website or in their publicity material and in their online stuff, they're putting my name. So Google understand this Subhobroto has been referred in 20 other medium. And that's how authority of Subhobroto goes up. So what you have to do, you write content for newspaper, magazine, online. The ones they put your name and they start tagging you, Google will increase your authority. That's so simple. Same thing, so growth, everybody wants growth. I see everybody. They are not willing to wait. If they forget, they're so impatient, most of us are so impatient. We want immediate gratifications, right? First, immediately. Even God take, I think, more than 9 months to produce a baby. It doesn't happen fast, right? So you expect the growth has to happen within the jiffy. Doesn't happen like that. So growth, organic growth, will take is a long game. You can run it for a long time without spending much. It takes time, but it's very, so it's like a steroid. If you have a healthy body and if you have a steroid, the moment you stopping steroid, your muscle will start sinking. Same thing happens with the paid growth. The moment you stop leads, the moment you stop spending money on Facebook, now you all must be seeing, whenever you post anything on Facebook, it don't reach more than 100, less 25, 10, 5. They pushed it in a manner, they said, first you pay me, then I'll spread. The algorithm is tightening. But in certain other platform, it is working wonderfully. I'm going to talk on TikTok. TikTok, if you post 1 or 2 or 3 content, you will find 100, 200, maybe a million people are coming and watching your content. So the algorithm is much more liberal there. How many brands are on TikTok? You will not find much. Okay. So paid and organic, paid is something which I will never recommend. Paid you do. But for a long term, you do only organic. Organic is a hard working job. You actually do it for a long, long time and then you get traction. Many followers is not as equal to influencers. So I see everybody is trying to be influencer. Tom, Dick, Harry, you know, especially girls have started coming up and saying, I'm a fashion designer, I'm a blogger. This is fun thing, you should put, apply, you know. And one is copying another one. Okay, I see. In fact, I wrote a blog on this, fake bloggers, the rise and the fall of fake bloggers and influencers, which I think is getting published today or tomorrow. I think Monday you guys are publishing. You can search it and you can read that. Influencer is, there's going to be a death of influencer fast because there are software which can also tells you, a lot of brands are coming in. I know Hindustan Levers and other brands are telling that, no, I don't want these followers. I don't want this influencer because we see 60% he has bought. It's not organic. So why will I pay for it? Okay. So don't buy followers and try to be, you know, have a self-satisfaction level at you are influencer. It means nothing. Okay. On page domain authority. I will not go this detail because I see from the faces that all of you are not that technically high, knowledge driven. I'll skip this few things. To summarize, yeah. You know, website is like it's not equal to a buffet lunch in the sense, I have done a website. My job is over now. oh my God, I've 3 months have tried, bought my head, got content writer, now I have nothing to do. Buffet lunch is actually last meals, a last supper, a last dinner's food, which, you know, this is a myth. I mean, we all know that this is not a myth. So website, you should actually put fresh content every week. The moment you do that, Google understand this authority or this website is getting fresh set of oxygen. The authority will keep going up. That's the fun. So it's not supposed to done it and forget it. How many of your college websites have an updated blog? You'll not find much. Only pictures. Or Independence Day, some cake day, some birthday day, you'll put some pictures. It means nothing. Content. By the way, do you know Google is blind? Google cannot understand image. Do you know that? Google cannot understand an apple or an orange. Because Google spider is blind. Google cannot read image. Google only can understand text. So when you put an image, you convert that image into a code called alt text. If you have not done it, all your image which you see, Google cannot see. So you'll never get find. That is the reason most of your picture will never surface on Google on an image search. And try my name. If you have 100 images of your first name, you will not find much except one or two LinkedIn may serve, because LinkedIn, if you are using regularly, it will. Otherwise, you will find girls or boys or some other people photographs coming if you do your own name in search. Yeah, this is also something I see. Everybody think content building is just once. I just wrote one content. Oh yeah, now there's not much responsibility. 5 videos, 6 content, 6 bloggers. Content, you have to do every day. It's like a daily dose. Do you sometime brush and sometime don't brush? So is content. Every day. Every single day. Biggest problem I see. Most people don't understand this. Content writer is not a copywriter. These are two different skills. Absolute two different skills. So what happens is that content copy guy in today's world, since no one knows this, they jump into a job and said, I can also write copy and I can also write content. So content and copy are two different skills. They have two different way of writing. So both of these people are not same. So if you hire one copy guy to save money or cost, and you try to say, okay, you write copy, also content, he or she will write either horrible content or horrible copy. This is the biggest problem. Everybody is an enthusiast. On a LinkedIn, I see Bitcoin enthusiast. Something is coming up, someone will be some enthusiast, AI enthusiast. Enthusiasts mean nothing, they're all fake words. If people ask you, even if you're a student, if you have so much of liberty, so much of command over that knowledge, you should really try to be a good marketeer. Don't try to be a fake or a half-baked marketeer. Life will catch you. Because people will come, because people will get a job because you have to solve certain problem. You will not able to solve. At that point, you can't say, no, I can't answer this actually, because in my suggestive question, this chapter I have missed in my last MBA class. Life catches you, and this will happen, you know what time? Just around 30-35, when you're in a decision making mode, and people and juniors will laugh at you, and they will know you're a fake title. You will not able to keep. I see many people going up in career and getting into a trap. Also, I'm in fact publishing another blog, the career trap blog. Okay, how people get into a career trap, and once you go in, you're not able to come out. Not that easy. So career trap is same mistake when you don't know what you are and whom you want to do. You try to fake certain personality, then never do that. Please have a full-hearted, you know. I see all of you guys are student here. So do an MBA, don't read that Philip Kotler few pages or few selection, do the entire book. Because life is going to ask you questions from different pages. So even if you get a first class, by the way, I'm a first class, doesn't mean anything to me. I have done my MBAs and whatever, education from IIM and all. I have put all my education degree into a dustbin. It has no use now. I believe I'm a learner. I got 4 or 5 years experience and I learned. So I'm not proud of my 25 years of experience. I am proud that I'm a upgradable version machine. So if you're not doing it, you will get obsolete. Definitely, because I see many of my friends are obsolete now. They are losing their job, will not able to make it up. Viral content is not a long-term content. So most people think, let's make a viral. So nothing called viral. If you actually do pure hard work of content, if you do every single day, month after month, year after year, good content will always get traction. You don't have to create virality. I see virality is an immediate gratification tendency or a temperament or a mindset. You don't have to look for that, right? do good content which helps people. I don't know how many people know this. I think all of you should read or watch Gary Vee. How many of you know Gary Vee here? Raise hands. Very few. My God. Obviously, you are expected. You are expected. So this, please follow Gary Vee. Okay. You will understand what I'm saying. So Bila content is a big content. So what I said in my earlier, you can talk about a content or a topic for a long hours, 1 hour. And you can then, you know, if you see this, there's a lady who's shooting my content here right now. She's actually building a pillar content because she is actually capturing a 45-minute session on what I'm talking. Now she's going to split this cut and make 15 seconds on Instagram. Then she used to make a one long video on YouTube. Then she used to take the voice, what I said, and convert that into a blog. It goes on a blog. That important blog, certain part, you chop it off and create a slide share. The most important thing I'm saying, you can actually pick it up and say, these are the 20 things you can tweet. That's how you make pillar content and micro content. It is happening in front of you. You can do that. No magic, hard work. Keyword stuffing is not a SEO strategy. Most people also don't know, understand this. So they said a lot of keywords, you know. If you put too much sugar, what will happen? Not able to eat that stuff. So keyword, primary should be only 3% on the entire text, not more than that. How do I know? By the way, I don't have a digital degree, you know. I don't have a digital degree. I speak in colleges and like I am. I don't have a digital degree. I'm a self-taught person. So you know, you can also learn, which if I can learn, you can also learn, right? But I learn all the time. I think I read more than you. Because you think you are finishing an MBA, after that you got a passport, you'll get a wonderful job in AC room and wonderful life is going to take off. You're going to put it on the Facebook status. I got a job in Wipro XYZ and a lot of likes expecting. Nothing is going to happen like that. Life is really, really hard. So make sure you understand the fundamentals of anything you do. Next, I spoke on this. My last slide. How many of you are on TikTok? Raise hands, don't feel shy, because I'm also on TikTok. No one, okay. TikTok is one of the most interesting channel which is growing at a very, very fast. Close to 1 billion people are using it. TikTok, if you, any of you, I don't know whether all of you know that channel which came and went back, Orkut? Right, we all came and went, vanished. TikTok has certain amount of credibility because the algorithm, it's a mass. Tier 2, Tier 3 cities are working on more on TikTok. So if you want to become a TikTok or TikToker or a content maker, or you can actually promote yourself, learn. People, I think college people, doctors, fake influencers also everybody's on TikTok. But TikTok is an amazing place which I'm trying to explore. I have put a lot of content, I'm testing it out. I'm testing the algorithm, I'm testing what format is the 60 seconds and the 15 seconds. I'm trying out, I think all of you should come explore that content because a time will happen very soon. TikTok will also reduce its algorithm. How hard you try will not get followers. Now with one picture or one post or one video, you can get 1 million followers. Okay, so that's the power.